Hi and welcome to Sciq. So it's been a month since the surprising and saddening election results came in, and the reality of a Trump presidency just keeps getting worse. As someone who agrees with Barack Obama that climate change is the greatest threat to humanity, I'm getting more and more depressed with where this presidency is heading. Recently, I was looking at this graph, which shows how much longer we can keep emitting carbon into the atmosphere before we hit 1.5 degrees of warming. Now, 1.5 degrees is considered to be a reversible situation. 2 degrees is kind of like the upper limit, the last line of defense that we defend at all costs. 1.5 is like 50% of reefs will die. There'll still be some ice left in the Arctic. So a situation that we can come back from. We want to keep warming below 1.5. But if according to this graph, we only have 5 years of carbon left if we keep emitting at the current rate. And given that Donald Trump has already indicated he's going to do nothing to fight climate change during his presidency, that leaves only 12 months, assuming he only serves one term, left to get the whole world down to zero emissions. This 4-year period was considered pretty much the last hope we have of mitigating climate change, and it was going to take some really strong international leadership. That's pretty much out the window after this election. Keeping climate change within acceptable limits is largely going to hinge on whether or not we can now convince President-elect Donald Trump to reduce carbon emissions during his term. But Trump has already openly displayed hostility towards the idea of any action on climate change, calling anthropomorphic climate change a hoax created by the Chinese, and suggesting he would withdraw the United States from the Paris Climate Accord. And this is not just rhetoric. Trump has already appointed a climate skeptic, Myron Ebell, to lead the Environmental Protection Agency during his transition period. This shows that his hostility towards climate change is more than just rhetoric. So if the whole idea of climate change is soon to become politically toxic, how can we, as people who care about clean water and fresh air and, you know, maybe coral reefs that we can visit, how can we convince President Trump that taking action on climate change is a good idea? That's a tough one. Well, first of all, climate scientists and the global community are going to have to stop using our usual line of argumentation about reducing emissions, sacrificing now to save the children of tomorrow, to have our message resonate with Trump. Instead of cuts, we're going to have to start talking about growth. Instead of sacrificing, we should be talking about winning. Or instead of reducing carbon emissions, we're going to have to start talking about building renewable energy. That's right, if we're going to have any chance at all to fight climate change, the time has come to focus on renewable energy. It's our way to change the dialogue of climate to fit within Trump's ideology, into strength and independence and making America great again. We have to show Trump that backing renewable energy is not just about saving the climate, it's about making the USA winners in the renewable energy race. It's about decreasing our dependence on other nations for energy. And since a large amount of renewable energy will be about building infrastructure, it definitely fits within Trump's $1 trillion infrastructure plan. It's almost like investing in renewable energy was Trump's idea all along. A renewables-only approach to climate change is not an ideal scenario, but basically at this point, it's the only way we're going to make headway against climate change in Trump's America. If you care about climate change and you think we need to take action, do me this one favor, please. Write to your congressman and ask them, whether they're Democratic or Republican, ask them to invest in renewable energy. It doesn't matter if you have to talk about the way it will increase jobs, about how you're concerned about America's dependence on other nations for energy. Whatever you have to do, please write to your congressman and get them to invest and to value renewable energy. This is our one shot, guys, and it's kind of depressing if we don't make us work. I, for one, am not willing to waste 4 more years doing nothing on climate change. So let's do something together.
Hi everyone, I'm Jade Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching Sciq, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.